Hello y'all, and welcome to the second installment of the Video Spotlight Year 1931. Next film up is a film directed by King Vidor, stars Wallace Beery, Jackie Cooper, and Irene Rich, and it's The Champ. This was remade in the late 1970s with Ricky Schroeder and John Voight. This was Wallace Beery's Academy Award winning performance. He actually got one less vote than his nominee, Frederick March. So back then the rule was if it's that close, they both got an Oscar. So it was a tie. This film is ranked the second best in the 1932 film Daily Poll by the National Critics. And it's only beaten by Grand Hotel. All right, the next film up is also another part of the Criterion Collection, and it's called A Nous la Liberté, directed by René Clair, stars Henri Marchand and Raymond Cordy. When Charlie Chaplin's, film that's about to come out on in the Criterion Collection as well, Modern Times premiered, the original distribution company of this film wanted to sue. But the director, René Clair, refused to join such a suit, saying he considered it a compliment if in fact, Charlie Chaplin based his film on Modern Times on this film. Which, was a good thing for him to do. And that lawsuit just, stayed with Mr. Chaplin his whole life. First film not in English to receive an Oscar nomination right here. So that's an interesting piece of trivia there. All right, next up is the 1931 version of Waterloo Bridge, and it's included on the Forbidden Hollywood Collection Volume 1. It's directed by James Whale again, who's famous for directing Frankenstein, and stars Mae Clark again, and I promise you again, no grapefruits were harmed in the making of this film. Also stars Douglas Montgomery and a really early screen appearance of Betty Davis. This was such a risque film, it was banned in the UK. The story of a ballet dancer who thinks her love has died and has to succumb to prostitution to make ends meet. Really some pre-code stuff here. Next up is Aerosmith, not the group, directed by John Ford, starring Ronald Coleman and Helen Hayes. This is the first American sound film to feature an African-American character who was actually a PhD in real life, who has, who's educated and has a university degree, and isn't, a stereotype as, being scared or, as how they were not politically correct, let's just say, back then. This also had four Oscar nominations, including Best Picture, right there. Four Oscar nominations. I don't know if you can see that, but unfortunately, it lost to Grand Hotel. Next up is a Carol Lombard film, which is included on the Carol Lombard The Glamour Collection, and it's directed by Richard Wallace. Stars William Powell, Carol Lombard, and the great, terrific character actor Guy Kibbe. I think he's very underrated, but he was in a lot of films. It's called Man of the World, and this is just one of 700 Paramount Productions filmed between 1929 and 49, which were sold to MCA Universal 1958 for television distribution, and it's been controlled by them ever since. A lot of studios, you know, back then did that. They sold off their entire catalogs, and those companies that picked up those catalogs have retained the rights to them all these years. All right, next up, and I know you've all seen this packaging before, and that's the Gloria Swanson collection for the film Indiscreet, directed by Leo McCarey, and it stars Gloria Swanson and Ben Lyon of the film with Gene Harlow, where he's a fighter pilot, Hell's Angels. Yes, he's of Hell's Angels fame, and that's really the only two films that I ever hear of Ben Lyon starring in. It was originally the film Indiscreet. I think you can see it down there on the bottom. Sorry for the glare and the blurriness of this. It's kind of dark in the house. New York Times said there were parts of this film that were Chaplin-esque, and actually, you know, if you're familiar with Gloria Swanson's work, she had a very what I deem a serious nature to her, and this is one of the roles she acts rather zany in, which wasn't typical of Gloria Swanson's performance. It was originally intended to be a musical, but you know, the songs were removed except for two when the film was released. So, let's see. I can't remember if I've seen this. I believe it's been remade. But it's definitely one to check out. If you can pick up this collection, I really highly recommend it. And the last film to round out 1931 is... and Alfred Hitchcock, I know you all have seen this one as well. On this collection, it's a movie called The Skin Game, and it stars C.V. France and Helen Hay, not to be confused with Helen Hayes. And a lot of critics, you know, pan The Skin Game as a low point in Hitchcock's career, you know, and I guess the man, you know, Hitchcock himself, you know, believed it. And it was rumored that he was so bored during the filming, you know, he actually gathered the actors and made impromptu demonstrations on how he wanted them to act. And according to his account, that his performances were much more vivid than they ever achieved themselves. So, you know, the man knew what he wanted, and, you know, deservedly so. The man was a genius, in my opinion, and... later, you know, he would prove that to the world, and that's Hitchcock's The Skin Game. And that rounds out my 1931. Thank you all for watching. Bye.